Good morning and welcome to today's show. As you can see, had a big old, I think it might be an oak tree that fell over. Used to be over here. This old gnarly tree. This is really gonna be tough to get rid of. I don't think the wood's gonna be any good at all. It's been dead for 30 years. Yeah, looking at the leaves, it looks like it's oak. And it's probably 80 foot long, where it was. Some of these branches broke off. It's gonna be a chore getting this out of here. I'm not sure if this branch was tore out of another tree. Probably what it was, because this tree has been dead for quite some time. But I'm slowly but surely dragging it out. I don't know if this 3930's got enough willpower to get that out of that hole back in there. But I'll go dig some more. Wasn't too much damage to the fence. Still got a big hunk of wood here. Still looking at 30 feet of it here. See the stump over there. Maybe you can see it better here than. But this is just a narrow path, and this tree couldn't have fell any better. I mean, it fell right down the middle of this path. Because if it fell over there, I guess it would have been the neighbor's problem. But I don't see. Must be up there somewhere. It must be a oak tree here somewhere that's missing half a branch. Watch out for the sun. Yeah, this is where we'll be working this fall, clearing a lot of this out, making this path hopefully twice as wide as what it is. You see, I can make me a path up through there real easily. There's already a path up there going crosswise, so I can connect these two. This thing is so big. This must be about 30 inches around right here. I don't know if my poor little saw can get through it or not, and I don't think I can drag it. May just have to leave it here. You can tell, but looking at it this direction, it's probably almost 4 foot across. It's hard to tell on the camera. Property goes on back here. Here's another path through the woods. I can get a tractor through there. I don't think I've ever showed you that part before. So this tree couldn't have fell any better if I'd have cut it down. I couldn't have cut it down and make it fall this way. It's up on this little hill. Guess these other trees guided it down. And let me get back to it. Good morning. This is day two of this big gnarly tree. At this end, it's 13 inches. And here's 16 feet here. Find a place to hook on to it. That slipped off. It's hard to do one-handed by yourself. This ain't gonna work. Let's try again. There's that cobweb. Ah, jeez. Here's about 10 more, and I probably got about 10 more, so 16, 26, 36. More cobwebs. Ah, I hate these things. And down here at the base, we're gonna be found a place to hook it. We're gonna be, yeah, just like I said yesterday, about 4 foot across. That's where she came from. I think what I'm gonna do, just for giggles, I'm gonna hook a chain to this. I don't know how solid this is. I may not even be able to budge it. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to cut it in half to get it out of here. But I'm gonna hook this chain up to it and see if I can even move this thing. So I'll be right back. All right, I got the chain hooked up. And you're gonna see this real time. just like I'm seeing it. I'm gonna see if I can move this at all. If not, I'll have to go back and get a saw. So let's get the tractor started, see what happens. I moved about 2 inches, just like I thought. This is too much weight, so I'm gonna have to go back and pick up a chainsaw and come back and we'll try round two. Hang in there, I'll be back. Oh, and welcome to today's show. Looks like the chemical I put in here did a pretty good job. The algae is mossed down. My deer over there, he's all but disappeared. I guess the turtles and fish did a number on him. Here you can pretty much see the bottom, some rocks in there. Well, I think I'll end it for today and get back to that big log maybe in the morning when I have some help. Kind of peaceful, quiet. Thanks for watching. See you next time.